Hello, it's Matt and welcome to Collaboration Coach. In this video, we're going to have a look at how we use Planner. And this is the third in a series of videos we're making on how we use Microsoft 365 apps. What you see here now is the planner that we use at Collaboration Coach. And you can see it's organized into buckets. Now the buckets are roughly tracked to the application or service that they relate to. So for example, we've got a bucket here called ScreenFlow. ScreenFlow is the editing tool that we use to create our videos for YouTube. And for every video we create a task inside of the ScreenFlow bucket, and that's how we complete the video until it's published. Then you can see I've got a bucket for Teachable. Teachable's the service that hosts our school. And there's lots of tasks we need to do to manage and support the Teachable environment. Things like creating images for the website, for example. Then I have a bucket for ConvertKit, which is our mailing list, and then one for coaching, which is all my customer work. So the one I want to focus on in this video is this ScreenFlow bucket. When I run the workflow that I talked about in the previous video, a new task will be created automatically for me based on the video title. And you can see here I've got one called New Video with the ID prefixing it. And if I open that up, you can see that it's been assigned to me, that was automatic, and it has a checklist of items that need to be completed. The reason we use this checklist is because there's a few steps involved in actually creating the video, and they may not all get done on the same day. So to keep track on where we are, we just tick these items off as we complete them. And there's also more than one person working on the video, so it's handy for them to know whereabouts in the flow of work we are. The other thing you can see here is this notes link. Again, this was created for me by the Power Automate workflow. And if I click on this, it will actually take me to the folder that all the video assets are in. So that's also stored in SharePoint in the document library that we looked at in the second video. So when I come here, I'll see things like scripts, the ScreenFlow, and any other assets that I need to create the video. So back in Planner, for every video task we create, I will assign it to the people that need to be involved. And I'll also add a label, which is basically a category to show me which app or service that that piece of content relates to. In this case, it's going to be a YouTube video. So I'll just choose YouTube as the category. So the last column on the left here is called This Week's Sprint. And this is how we use Planner to plan our weekly tasks. So every week, at the beginning of the week, we set this column up with all the tasks that we want to complete that week. After I've created the task in the ScreenFlow bucket, I drag it into this week's sprint bucket, and now I know that that's a task that we want to complete before the end of the week. Another thing I can do with each of these tasks is to add a due date. If I open up my new video and choose a due date, say the 29th of October. That is now added to the schedule view so I can see at a glance all the tasks that have a due date added. So if I close this now and go to schedule, you'll see now each of these rectangles is a task that's had a due date assigned to it. Now here's my new video here and I can move that around so you can manage when tasks should actually be completed. And this is really useful for me because obviously we publish videos to our YouTube channel on a schedule. This allows me to see all the videos that have been completed, which are the green ones with the tick, all the videos that are being worked on, these gray ones with the circle symbol in them, and also the ones that we haven't started working on yet. Okay, so that's a quick overview of how we manage the work that we do at Collaboration Coach using Planner. And in the next video, I'll show you how I do my personal task management in Microsoft To Do. So thanks for watching and I'll see you next time.